Okay, just opened the box of the smart roller, the Wagner smart roller, and there's a few pieces. You know, you got your main part there on the left, and you got your roller cover, little parts here and there. So I'm going to snap those together, and I'll tell you.
Today we're going to be looking at starting the Wagner smart roller, and you just fill it with paint and start going. So apparently you can do like 2 sheets of plywood, which would be like 64 square feet for every fill-up. And this tube here just fills up with paint, and you just start rolling out so you can get, without having to fill it again, so you can do like 64 square feet. It says 70 square feet, so two pieces of plywood or drywall is 64 square feet if you're talking about a 4x8. So anyway, we're going to give this a shot, and I'll do an individual video and see how it's like. At the same time we're going to do this video, we're going to do a video on the Wagner Sidekick. I'll do individual videos though, okay? So we're going to try them both today. So we'll start with this one.
The Wagner. Okay, what you want to do is whenever you're using any kind of paint, brand new or not, is strain it. If you're going to use any kind of equipment, we're today again, we're using this Wagner Sidekick. And if you want to use any kind of equipment, you want to make sure you strain it with a strainer. So go grab yourself a 5-gallon strainer. And that's not worth buying the 1-gallon strainers, even if you're only doing 1 gallon. It's simply not worth it. Just buy a 5-gallon strainer or two and put your paint in it. And I'll show you exactly how to do that. So you just dump it in there, then you pull it out. Use your hand to take the rest out, and then you clean your hand up and you're ready to go. It's all strained. Because any kind of particulates in the paint, there's a lot in paint. It doesn't matter if it's brand new or not. If it's old, especially. So if it's brand new, you want to start off with a nice clean bucket like we have here. And so the bucket's perfectly clean. And you just take a strainer. Bucket's all clean. Take a strainer. Put it on there with a little elastic on it. And you're ready to strain through. Okay, I'll show you that process. It's on. Mm-hmm. All right, so you got a nice clean bucket. And you take your elastic strainer. Put it on there. And then you'll take your paint and just dump it in. Once you dump it in there, you just undo it like this. You'll pull it up and squeeze it just like that, right on out. And once you do that, you only got a little bit of paint on your hands. Just wash it out in your bucket of water. You should always have a bucket of water with you, always for any job. It's already there, cleaned up, ready to go. Okay, it says to pull this thing out. You undo this little nut right here. You pull the whole thing out and you lubricate the inside with petroleum jelly. It says in the instructions that it comes with it, but it didn't come with it. And it had to look like I had a little bit of film on there because it didn't come with it. So I went ahead and tried it. And I go ahead and pull it out, James. Try it, put it back in the paint and try it. Okay, it doesn't do anything. As you can see, it doesn't pull the paint in. So go ahead and push it back in, James. It pushes it back out, so it has some kind of pressure on there. It was able to push it back out, but it wouldn't suck any in. So much for that. So we're going to clean it up and take that back too. So far I didn't like either of these things. So the smart roller didn't work for me at all. And I know what the hell I'm doing. So it really wouldn't work for somebody who did have no idea what's going on. That didn't work, and neither did this the other one. What was it called? I don't know what the other one was called. But anyway, the other Wagner product also was sucky. Watch both videos if you don't want to do it. Both of them sucked. As far as the smart roller, I couldn't get it to work at all. Again, the tube, let's see, it's right here. The tube, I couldn't get it to pressurize at all, so I couldn't suck paint into it. It's supposed to be designed to do that. I didn't buy two of them and tried both of them. I bought one, tried it, didn't work, and I'm not buying another one to find out if it's just that one that was bad. That's the problem when you have a system like this. If you don't know for sure it works, you just assume the whole system don't work. Maybe the next one works perfectly. Who knows? I'm not going to try it again. I tried it once. It's out. It comes with a 1-gallon bucket thing for your tube to do with paint. You're really not designed for a 5-gallon bucket. You can buy optionally a different system for a 5-gallon bucket, but they don't give it to you in this one. So if you're going to use this system, lubricate it. That was the issue. Lubricate that. They say to lubricate it. It says they give you, on the instructions it says we gave you lubrication, but they didn't. And so I had nothing. I tried it with nothing, and it didn't work with nothing. So there you go. It was slippery, though. I mean, they did have some at the factory done, but not enough to pull the suction. Okay, so in other words, I wouldn't buy this one either.